Hey everyone, welcome back to Chill Vibes Only. Today's video is going to be on the incentive model and how it relates to low sexual desire. So I learned about the incentive model in Dr. Lori Brado's book on better sex through mindfulness, and basically it touches on, and what we'll get into today is how we think about what drives our desire and what makes us want to feel desired and incentivize sex versus what might be portrayed to us in media throughout our life cycle. Although some people may believe that the longer we go without sex, the more we crave and want it. So if you think about like food or water, right? The longer you go without food and water, the more you're craving the food and water. But sex isn't like that. Sex isn't a necessity. We don't need it to live. No matter what anybody says to you, you don't need it to be happy. And sex doesn't follow that same sort of incentivization and needing and wanting like those other things in our lives that we actually need to survive. So the first myth that I want to just kind of debunk right away is that the myth that you need sex. Some people will say like, I can't live without it, and the more they don't have it, the more they want it. But lots of women actually experience the opposite. So they experience that the less they have sex, the less they actually want it, and the more they realize that they can live without it. Which really taps into that cycle of low desire, because the longer and longer you go on without something, and you notice like maybe you don't miss it, right? And we talk about things on this channel about why we might not be desiring sex or sexual activities, and it could be because of the type of sex that we're having, it being really like lacklustered or not interesting to us. Why would we desire something that we don't actually like? Or we could be going through a stressful time, so we might be focusing on other things in our lives that are causing us a lot of stress and anxiety, and sex just isn't on our priority list. Or we simply just could not have an interest in it. There are lots of reasons why people don't desire sex. And so we're going to talk about the incentive model and how it can help you think about, you know, what make you actually start to increase your desire. But know that, you know, this is a normal thing. It's not something that we need to live. And it's not something that the longer you go without it, the more you're going to crave it. So women who are not having a lot of sex, it actually, you know, the desire for it tends to decrease. And usually the only reason why they are incentivized is just to keep their partner happy, which can cause a lot of resentment and anger and start to deteriorate the relationship, which obviously isn't sustainable. And so we want to work on other ways that we can increase our desire if you want to. So sexual response is just like other emotional responses. It has to be associated to some sort of trigger. So, you know, someone comes and gets you brand new AirPods, right? That's usually going to trigger excitement and happiness and joy and gratitude in you. So sexual desire is the exact same. Something has to happen that triggers you into having that emotion and having that desire show up. Similar to happiness, it doesn't reside in our body. Sexual desire is in relation to something in your environment. So going off of that, and that sexual desire relates to the incentive model, Dr. Lori Brado's research suggests that the incentive motivation model also states that your sexual reaction is influenced by, among other things, your biology, hormones, and neurotransmitters, which are all chemical messengers released by the brain. So attention is critical for what you do in response to the sexual trigger. Attention mechanisms, which is largely tied to memory, determine whether you attach a sexual versus a non-sexual meaning to the trigger based on your past experiences with that type of trigger. So what she's saying here and what the research shows is that the incentive motivation model for sexual desire depends on A, having the trigger there, so something happens that's going to make you want to desire that trigger, but B, having the attention to notice the trigger. So oftentimes, you know, you've heard me on this channel talk before about accelerators and brakes. Check out our videos down below to learn about how you can kind of uncover and decide on your accelerators and brakes. But you have to be able to pay attention to pick up when your accelerators are getting turned on. So having that attention there for the trigger is important. And then also to your relationship to that trigger. So is it a positive experience, right? Like if the trigger is your brake, obviously sexual desire isn't going to be established, right? But if a trigger is one of your accelerators, then it is. So the first thing obviously is having the trigger present there. The trigger needs to show up, but you also have to be aware of that trigger. So say if, you know, the trigger's there, it's one of your accelerators, and it's positive, you're having a positive response to it, and you're aware of it, that's what's going to send the cues to your brain to say, hey, yeah, I'm turned on, I like this, and your brain is going to indicate to your body to start to do the things that allow you to feel turned on. So that might be, you know, getting wet. It's not always that case. There is non-coordinance, but that could be a reaction, or maybe you might want to get physically close or touch your partner, and you might start to feel sensations in your body that usually aren't present when you're not in that state. So overall, the research time and time again proves that this idea of spontaneous sexual desire, so just feeling randomly like you have a strong sexual desire, is not common. Responsive sexual desire and tapping into those triggers and tapping into those incentives, knowing that they accelerate you and you're paying attention, is what actually cultivates that desire and improves it. So if you feel like you're a woman who's struggling with low desire recently, I would start to talk to your partner honestly and openly about it. I would eliminate the times that you're having sex just to please them, and instead work on knowing your brakes, knowing your accelerators, turning the brakes off, turning the accelerators on, and then practicing mindfulness so you can pay attention and notice what's going on in your body and not be distracted by other thoughts, so that when these cues and triggers do come up, you don't miss them. A lot of times in the incentive motivation model, the accelerators are there, the situation's right, but because you're not being present and aware and picking up on the cues, your body and your mind are disconnected and you don't feel like you're sexually aroused when you actually might be. So moral of the story here is that, you know, low desire is normal and natural. Sex is not something that we need, it's something that we want. It's based off of incentives and triggers in our environment. And in order to increase desire, we need to pay attention to those triggers and create that mind-body connection by being present in the moment and paying attention to how we're feeling. And also dropping the narrative that spontaneous desire is what should naturally be happening, because it's not. And instead training ourselves by using mindfulness and awareness to tap into these other strategies to help increase our desire. So I hope you guys found this video helpful. Please leave a comment down below if you have any questions, or if you like this video, give it a big thumbs up, because that really helps this channel. Definitely check out our Instagram page at CBO Wellness for more positive sex information and education. And if you are interested in mindfulness training, so mindfulness to help increase sexual desire, we do have an 8-week program. Please send me a DM on Instagram and I will help you get set up on that. It's a great 8-week program. It teaches you how to increase sexual desire through mindfulness. And we had a lot of positive responses from it. So if you're interested in that, let me know, send me a DM, and I can definitely help you out. Okay, I hope you guys are having a great day, and we'll see you for another video shortly.